people just love to gossip, di ba? You know, I was working in a company once and I remember walking in the office hallway and there's this group of employees packed into a small cubicle. They were talking in whispers and they were occasionally bursting out in giggles. Naintriga ako at hindi ko naman sinasadya pero narinig ko pinag-uusapan pala nila yung aming boss. Now, I'm not particularly fond of our boss. Everybody in the office knew how my boss and I would often get into serious clashes during meetings because of, you know, we had differences of ideas and approaches. But I felt that what these employees were doing was wrong. So I jumped into their discussion and defended our boss. That quickly broke up the small meeting. Tapos ang kwento. I no longer found out if I became their next topic of conversation, of course, but I didn't care. Everywhere there's a group of people in a huddle and deeply engaged in discussion, there's a very strong temptation for these conversations to drift into topics they have no business talking about, like gossip. No? They will be tempted to talk about other people on matters they have no direct knowledge of and probably just heard from the grapevine. Gossip is so insidious, quite evil, I think. I tell you, we need to develop strong sensors for gossip. Once we hear it, we must take steps to stop it. The Bible does not have anything good to say about gossip. In fact, the book of Proverbs portrays gossips in a not so positive light. Here's what we read in the book of Proverbs. Whoever goes about slandering reveals secrets, but he who is trustworthy in spirit keeps a thing covered. You know, in the Hebrew language, the word used to mean slanderer or the one who goes about slandering is directly translated as peddler of scandal. You know, it evokes the image of someone who goes out and offers to people malicious pieces of information that are scandalous and may hurt the reputation of another person. That's exactly what a gossip does, right? They are peddlers of scandal. Naglalako ng iskandalo. A follower of Jesus needs to be very prudent about information that comes to his attention that may possibly be damaging to the reputation of another person. We need to keep our mouths shut. We need to keep these sensitive things covered, not to conceal per se, but to protect the reputation of the person. Because sometimes gossip can be disguised as a prayer request. You know, yung sister or brother, uy, pag-pray naman natin si ano, kasi alam mo ba, di ba? We should not allow gossip to go past us. Gossip will not go any further. Gossip that passes through us must lie dead in its tracks. Kung may makarating na chismis sa atin, hanggang sa atin na lang yun. Hindi na dapat ipasa pa sa iba. At lalong wag natin gawing viral. So, don't be a peddler of scandal. Don't participate in the spread of gossip. When you hear people talking maliciously about somebody else, either avoid them and don't listen to them, or try to intervene and warn them about what they're doing. If malicious information is passed on to you inadvertently, let the spread of the information end with you. As you avoid being a peddler of scandal and prevent gossip from spreading, and as you grow to be a trustworthy person who can keep damaging information in complete confidence, keep in mind, faith matters too.